Good evening, everyone. This is Sunil Katke from AxisDirect Mumbai. We thought we will have a webinar for our clients, especially the clients who are very new to commodities. This is something which is a very simple and crisp presentation, and I thought we can share with you the simple ways you can participate in commodities. You can also understand the concept of commodities in next half an hour's time that we have. So without further ado, I think let us start understanding the concept of commodities. First of all, what comes to your mind when we hear the word commodity? So commodities are nothing but raw materials that have a value. So like when we ask what is a share, we normally know okay, share is nothing but the right of ownership in a particular company. If I have invested 100 rupees in a company whose valuation is 1000, then I can say okay, I own 10% shares of that company. So similarly, when it comes to commodities, it is nothing but a raw material which has a value. And commodity as a raw material, its value fluctuates up and down. And this fluctuation actually provides trading opportunity for a lot of traders, investors. At the same time, it provides an opportunity to manage commodity price risk for the physical participants in commodities. Commodities are very much similar to equities. When I say similar, it is from the conceptual side. Why we invest in equities? We buy shares at a lesser price and we sell at a higher price to make good of the price rise. At the same time, in commodities also my objective is same. I buy a commodity at 100 rupees and I try to sell it at 125 rupees. So basically my idea here is to ensure that I make the profitability out of the positive movement in commodity prices. So if I move to the next slide now, first thing that you need to understand is that product knowledge, is it very important to participate? Because I have met a lot of clients. I asked them a simple question, okay, why you have been active in equity and not in commodity from last 5 years or 10 years. Normally I hear a response saying, okay, I have experience of trading in commodity. I have product knowledge in, I have product knowledge in equity. I have experience in equity. That's why I continue trading in equity. When it comes to commodity, I'm very new and I do have limited knowledge, or I don't have any knowledge at all. That is the reason why I don't trade in commodities. So when I ask them in detail, what stock you bought yesterday, they say, okay, I have bought this XYZ stock. When I ask them, what is the quarterly result of that stock that they bought yesterday, they have no idea of the same. So basically, when you say you have knowledge, we may have only knowledge of the current price and what price the research person is telling us in a month or 2 months time. In terms of company, I may have limited knowledge. So similarly, in commodities also, you will not have 100% knowledge even if you spend 10 years of time. You will keep on learning. Every time you will tend to learn something new about commodities. In simple terms, if you want to participate with limited knowledge in commodity, you just need to have a strategy. So I have just highlighted an example here in this slide. If a person doesn't know swimming, can he enjoy the pool which has a depth of 10 feet? So if my height is 5.5 or 6 feet, pool depth is 10 feet, and I don't know swimming, so will I be able to use the pool? Some may say, hey, you cannot, because obviously you don't know swimming, so you may drown. But some may say you may use the pool, subject to you use a life jacket. So idea here is, if you have a strategy in place, like in this case, even though I did not know swimming, since I used a life jacket, I was able to use the swimming pool, which had a depth of 10 feet without drowning. So similarly, if you have limited knowledge in commodities, still you can participate safely and you can make the most of the volatility by using a life jacket called strategy. So if you put a strategy in place, every product becomes safe. I will also cover some of the simple ways you can make commodities safer. And just to reiterate, the heading, like it says, is product knowledge very important? I would say ki product knowledge is important, but it is not necessary or it is not essential. You just need to have a strategy in place so that you can still participate in a product, because knowledge is something which will keep on growing, which will keep on learning. We will never become 100% knowledgeable in any product, be it equity or commodity. We'll keep on learning new things. If we have a strategy, we will find a way to make the most of volatility. So I'll just move to the next slide. Like I mentioned in the beginning of the webinar, what are commodities? So commodities are nothing but raw materials whose value is derived from the underlying asset. So when I say what is a share, share is nothing but it is a financial instrument whose value is derived from the underlying company and its performance. So similarly, when I say what is commodity, commodity is nothing but a raw material. When I say commodity derivatives, so it is a contract whose value is derived from the underlying raw material. So simple example for it, if I am talking about, say, chana, for example, in agri commodity. So chana is a raw material. If I am trading on exchange platform a contract of chana, say, like I share, like I trade in a share, company's share listed on exchange. So likewise, a chana contract is listed on a commodity exchange, or a gold contract is listed on a commodity exchange, and these contracts' value is derived from the underlying asset. If tomorrow chana prices in physical market goes up, the contract value also goes up and I'll end up making profits. Similarly, if I have bought a gold contract at say 33,000 rupees per 10 gram, and if this price moves up from 33,000 rupees to 34,000 rupees, I will make 1,000 rupees profit per 10 grams. So it is similar to shares. In shares also, you buy at a lesser price and sell at a higher price. You buy shares which have good fundamentals, which has positive news. Similarly, in commodities also, a research team recommends you to buy or sell a commodity based on its supply and demand aspects. Where if supply is less, demand is more, normally the prices tend to go up. That is when you receive a buy call. When the supply is more and demand is less, the prices normally come down, and that is when you receive a sell call. Even you can trade in commodities contracts on electronic platform on an intraday basis using the technical levels. Research team provides support and resistance levels. They also provide a full-fledged recommendation of buying or selling with a stop loss and a target. So basically, you can trade on a day basis, you can trade on a week basis, you can trade on a month basis. In total, in commodities, the contract time frame is up to 6 months to 8 months. So in a way, if you are an investor, you want to buy and keep a stock, or you want to buy and hold a commodity contract for 6 months, you can do that. In a way, if you want to trade intraday, you can buy and sell it on the same day also. Now, how the commodity contracts work on an electronic platform? So now, like we have Nifty, Bank Nifty, and stock futures and options trading on NSE and BSE platform, we have two commodity exchanges, national level commodity exchanges, which are fully established. Multi-commodity exchange, which we call it as MCX, and National Commodities and Derivative Exchange, which is NCDEX. Apart from that, recently, a couple of months back, we also saw NSE and BSE coming out with commodity exchange. So even NSE and BSE are a part of commodity exchange now. Even they allow you to participate in commodity contracts. So commodities are very much similar to Nifty or Bank Nifty contracts. Similarities like, Nifty has a lot size, say of 75. Likewise, commodities do have a lot size. When you talk about gold as a contract, the lot size is 1 kg. When you talk about silver contract, the lot size is 30 kg. Crude oil contract, the lot size is 100 barrel. Copper contract, the lot size is 1000 kg. So likewise, all commodities that are traded on exchange platform, they have a lot size. The lot size are predefined by exchange. So if I'm buying one lot of gold, that means I'm buying 1 kg of gold. If I want to buy more, then I can buy two lots of gold, which is 2 kg of gold. Now, in order to participate or buy or sell a contract of commodity, the time frame is different. You can buy 1 month contract, you can buy 2 month contract, you can buy 6 months contract also. So time frame is something which the investor or trader decides. Somebody who is willing to buy a contract, who is very bullish on gold prices or crude oil prices or copper prices for a month or 2 months, they will normally buy a contract and hold it for a one or two months time. But somebody who is looking for 5-10,000 rupees profit in a day, they normally go for an intraday trade. They buy say crude oil at 3,900, for example, and they sell at 4,000. That makes them a profit of 100 rupees per barrel. Since the lot size is 100 barrels, then 100 into 100 is 10,000 rupees is his gross profit. This is how people do trade. The biggest plus point of commodity trading is it starts in the morning at 9 a.m. and it closes by 11:55 at night. So it is a 15-hour market, Monday to Friday market. So you get to participate in commodity even when you come back from your office or your business. This is something which is liked by a lot of people. In the evening, normally the international market, US market, starts around 6:30. That is when the actual movement starts also in commodities, and that is when people tend to use the research recommendations for buying and selling. They do get in touch with our central dealing desk, where the experienced dealers do advise clients based on the research report and the research recommendation. One more advantage of trading in commodity contracts is that you just need to invest 5-7% of the contract value to participate in commodities. So simple example I'll give you. If I want to buy a commodity worth 100 rupees, I just need to invest 5-7 rupees as margin money. It is similar to Nifty. Say for example, you want to buy one lot of Nifty, you are investing 10% of the contract value. Say 70-80,000 rupees is what you are investing, and you are buying one lot of Nifty, or you are selling one lot of Nifty. Similarly, in commodities, if you are buying one lot of gold, one lot of gold is nothing but 1 kg gold. The contract value is, say, 33 lakh rupees. So I will be investing 5% of that, which is 1,60,000 rupees, to buy one lot gold and hold it for 3 months, 4 months time. The best part is, if you are trading intraday, you will only pay 1-2% of the margin. That means for carrying it to the next day, you will pay 5-7% margin. For trading intraday, you are only paying 1-2% of the margin. So for gold, if you want to buy and carry to the next day, you're paying 1,70,000 rupees as 5% of 33 lakh. For trading intraday, possibly with 50-60,000 rupees, you can still buy and sell gold in intraday, because intraday leverages are up to 3-5 times. So you'll get to trade in commodities with an intraday exposure of 3x-5x. So this is something which is an advantage. So your margin money required is very low. That means your leverages are very high. So that gives you an opportunity to buy and sell at a lesser investment. We normally recommend investors or traders who wish to keep the position for more than one day to invest at least 8-10% of the contract value, just to be on a safer side because of the day-to-day mark-to-market. So ideally, if you are a day trader, you can use 3x-5x leverage and buy and sell it intraday. And if you are a positional trader, you want to hold it for a month, one week or 10 days. Normally, we advise you to invest 7-10% of the commodity value so that price up or down movement should not impact your performance. Now, many of us do ask, is commodity trading risky? I have money, but I am scared, of trading in commodity because I have heard from people that it is risky. But in reality, I'll tell you, if you use a strategy, if you use a process in a disciplined manner, if you participate, every product is safe. If you are participating in any of the segment without discipline, then you are increasing your risk. So commodity is just another asset class. It has its own benefits if you use it right way. So in this webinar, we will try to understand what is the right way of participating in commodity also. Now, who are the participants in commodities? Who normally participate in commodity? Any retail investor or trader like you or me can participate in commodity. It is not necessary that people who have commodity exposure, who are jewelers or who are agri merchants, should participate in commodity. It is not true. any person who has money, who wants to invest and make the most of price rise or price fall, can be a participant in commodity. A lot of people use commodity as a tool to hedge their physical commodity price risk. A lot of people use commodities to diversify their investment. If I have a portfolio of 50 lakh in equity already, I would like to put 5-7 lakh rupees in commodity also, just to diversify. Like they say, do not put all your eggs in a single basket. You should always explore the new products with a systematic strategy in place. So who are the participants? Just to reiterate again, any retail investor like you and me, corporates, MSMEs, producers, consumers can participate in commodities for trading purpose, for investment purpose, or for hedging purpose also. Now, commodity derivatives in India started in the year 2003. So that makes it 16-year-old market. Like I mentioned already, there are four exchanges, MCX, NCDX, NSE and BSE. More than 30 commodities are actively traded, so it is quite easy to track. On an average, we see a volume of 30,000 crore and the turnover is growing day by day. On a good day, the turnover has even crossed 1 lakh crore in commodities in a day. So that shows its potential. In commodities, you have futures and option contracts available up to 3 to 6 months time. That means you can actually select a contract as per your liking from 1 month validity to 6 months validity. And you have futures and option contracts both available for your advantage. Like I mentioned, retail investors, traders, corporates, farmers, large scale consumers, hedgers, MSMEs participate in commodities. In fact, you will be surprised to know that 75% of the volume comes from retail investors or traders who have nothing to do with commodities in physical market. So that I think clears the misconception that commodity is not for me or it is only for the people who are into commodities business. No, it is not true. 75% of the volume comes from retail investors who have nothing to do with commodities. They're just participating as a trader or as an investor, similar to the way they are participating in equity market. The biggest advantage, like I have already mentioned, the market in the morning starts at 9 a.m. and closes by 11:55 p.m. That makes it a 15 hours market, 15 hours opportunity per day. And you should be in a position to make the most of this timing available. What are the different types of commodities listed? Like I mentioned, around 30 commodities are listed. Out of that, few popular commodities I have listed here. Broadly, there are four categories of commodities: precious metal, base metal, energy, and agri. In precious metal, you have gold and silver, actively traded commodities. Base metals are nothing but industrial metals like copper, zinc, lead, nickel, aluminium. In energy segment, we have crude oil or natural gas. These two energy products are actively traded, crude being the number one commodity with highest volume. Agri commodities, you have gaur seed, chana, soya oil, soya bean, jeera, turmeric, etc. So these are the widely traded commodities. Apart from that, like I mentioned, there are in total 30 commodities that are actively traded. Concept, how these commodities are traded on exchange platform. Like I mentioned, it comes in a lot size. Lot is nothing but minimum quantity to be bought and sold. So if I'm buying gold, I cannot buy, say, 3 grams or 4 grams like that. I can buy 1 kg gold, for example, as a 1 kg lot gold has. Silver, if I want to buy, 30 kg is the lot size. Silver mini contract, you can buy 5 kg silver mini. In gold also, there is a mini contract where you can buy 100 grams of gold. Crude oil, 100 barrels is the lot size. So in order to avoid confusion, I think we can better use shares as a word. So when I say crude oil, I can say instead of 100 barrel, I will say 100 shares of crude oil. I think that will mostly simplify the way you see this market. When I say copper, I will say 1,000 shares as a lot size. When I say zinc, it is a 5,000 shares of zinc. When I say chana, it is say 100 shares of chana. When I say guar seed, again, it is 100 shares of guar seed. So soya bean, 100 shares of soya bean. So this becomes quite easy because you understand the language of shares. So when I say kg or barrels or tons, you may think that it is totally different, but it is not. It is just another share. Like I said, for gold, it is 100 shares as a lot. For silver, it is 30 shares lot. Crude oil, 100 shares lot, and copper, 1,000 shares lot. Likewise, chana, 100 shares lot, and likewise, guar seed, 100 guar seed lot. So this is something which simplifies the understanding. You're buying a share and you're anticipating the prices to move up. And once they move up, you'll make that much profit, the amount of shares that you have bought, that much profit you'll make. So now, all commodities are listed in standard lots, which means minimum quantities predefined that you can buy and sell. So crude oil, 100 shares is the minimum quantity you can buy and sell. If you want to buy more, then 200, 300, that you can call it as one lot, two lot, three lot. So it is similar to Nifty, where Nifty lot size is 75. So Nifty's lot size is predefined as 75 quantity. Likewise, gold quantity is defined as 1 kg as a lot. Crude oil is 100 barrels as a lot. And likewise, copper is 1000 kg as a lot. Margin money. Like I mentioned, to participate in commodity, you don't have to invest 100% of the commodity value. You just need to put in 5 to 7% of the total contract value. So in similar terms, if I give you an example, if I am buying rupees 100 worth of a commodity, I just need to put in 5 rupees as an investment. If that price goes up to 103, I will make 3 rupees profit on 5 rupees investment. So basically, this is how it works. So margin money is nothing but the initial margin that you invest, which is in the range of 5 to 7% of commodity value. Now, what is a mark to market? Mark to market is nothing but the price difference between the current price and the price at which you had bought or sold. So if I have bought a commodity at rupees 100 and current price is 110, so I am on a positive mark to market of 10 rupees. I am making a profit of 10 rupees. It is a notional profit, which is called as mark to market. But if I bought at 100 and if the price is 90 now, I am on a negative mark to market of rupees 10. So basically, in order to participate in commodity, if the mark to market is negative, that much money you will have to pump in. So you'll have to make a top up of the mark to market money that you have on the short side. On the plus side, if the mark to market is on the positive side, you can withdraw that, any point of time. Now, contract expiry. So like I said, commodities are traded in the form of contracts. Contracts are nothing but minimum lot is specified, minimum margin is specified, and minimum expiry date is also specified. So quality is also specified in commodities. So contract expiry is nothing but 1 month expiry, 2 month, 3 month, 4 month, 5 month, 6 month. So you have contracts in all commodities from 1 month to 6 months contracts. You can select your contract based on your time frame. If I want to invest in gold till April, I will buy 2 months contract. If I want to invest in gold till August, I'll buy 6 months contract. So likewise, if I want to only do intraday trade, then I'll trade in current contract only. Say February contract only I will trade if I want to trade on an intraday basis. Now the concept of rollover, many clients may say, I'm not a speculator, I'm not a trader, I'm an investor. I would like to buy and hold a commodity for 6 months, 1 year. So somebody who wants to hold a commodity for 1 year, they can buy a commodity and every 6 months they can just square off that position and buy the next 6 month contract. So that is called as rollover. So you're exiting the contract on contract expiry and you can just buy a fresh contract 10 months, 6 months ahead to carry your position. So that is called as a rollover. I'm just highlighting the list of commodities and their lot size and their tick size. 1 rupee movement profit or loss also I'm highlighting. What is the intraday margin? If you are trading on an intraday basis in a crude oil, for example, your margin requirement is 20,000. If you're trading in gold, like I mentioned, your margin requirement is 60,000. So I'm just using the cursor to highlight. This is the exchange, MCX or NCDX. These are the commodities, list of commodities I have added. I have missed a lot of commodities, but due to lack of space, I have only included the important commodities. This is lot size. This is lot size. Lot size is nothing but the minimum quantity that you're buying or selling. This is the tick size, 1 rupee movement, how much plus or minus it gives. For 1 rupee, you get 100 rupees profit or loss. This is intraday margin. Like I mentioned, to trade in crude oil, your intraday margin requirement is 20,000. To trade in gold, your requirement is 60,000. To trade in silver, your requirement is 20,000. Carry forward margin, if you want to buy and hold it to the next day, this is the margin that is required. So for crude oil, your carry forward margin means you want to buy today and you want to carry it to the next day, your margin requirement will be 60,000 rupees. So likewise, average daily volatility also I have highlighted here. So average daily volatility is nothing but normal average movement that we see in these commodities on a daily basis. So when I say 120 in crude oil, so crude oil moves up or down, high to low, the moment is up to 120 rupees. That means if I buy at the lowest point and if I sell at the highest point, I will make 12,000 rupees profit intraday for an investment of 20,000 rupees. So just an example I gave. So 120 rupees is the daily volatility. You may never be able to buy at the lowest and sell at the highest, but in a way you can always target 50-60 point crude oil in a daily basis to target and earn 5 to 6,000 rupees profit. Likewise, gold has a volatility of 300 points every day. Silver has a movement of 500 rupees. Copper has a movement of six rupees. Zinc has a movement of 3 rupees. Chana has a movement of 50 rupees. Soybean has a movement of 40 rupees. Likewise, guar seed has a movement of 80 rupees. So, for example, zinc, you may see the movement is only 3 rupees. So, since the lot size is 5,000 kg, so 5,000 shares is what you're buying and selling, 3 rupees movement is nothing but 15,000 rupees profit or loss. So wherever the movement is less, the lot size is big. And that is where the ticks, you can see it is in 5 paise. So every tick there is not 1 rupee, it is 5 paise. For example, copper or zinc. The last column that I have given is the normal stop loss and target range we normally recommend to a new investor. Now, this is the stop loss and target you can normally maintain to be on a safer side. You can see one thing that the stop loss and target range is having a minimum of 1:2 risk reward ratio. This is something which minimum one should focus on. Risk reward ratio should never be less than 1:2. If I'm risking 1 rupee, I should target minimum 2 rupees. Now, coming to the point, how do I get started in commodities? Basically, in 3 simple steps, you can get started in commodity. First and foremost thing, select any one of the commodity. As a new investor, I don't think so you will need 8-10 commodities to experiment or to speculate. As a new investor, you just need to select any one commodity. Say, for example, if I'm new to F&O segment in equity, I would only trade in Nifty for some time till the time I get used to F&O. So similarly, in commodities, if you are very new to commodities, then go for any one commodity, one active commodity. So in this example, I have taken crude oil as a active commodity. So crude oil lot size is 100 shares. Intraday margin is 20,000 rupees and carry forward margin is 60,000 rupees. So if I'm trading in crude oil every day, intraday basis, I'm only supposed to invest 20,000 rupees. If I'm willing to carry to the next day, possibly I'll have to invest 60,000 rupees. The lot size is 100 for crude oil. So once I select a commodity, like I said, the margin money or investment is 20,000 rupees as per 5% of the contract value. So crude oil current price is 3,900 per share. 100 shares value comes to be around 4 lakh rupees. So 4 lakh is the contract value. So 4 lakh into 5% is 20,000 rupees. So 20,000 is my intraday margin in crude oil. So this is how I can participate in commodities. First step I did, select any one commodity. I selected crude oil. Second step is invest the 5% margin, which is 20,000 rupees to trade intraday. And third step is, if you are new, follow the recommendation given by the research team. So for example, I have also given an example how the call looks. So if there is a call in crude, say for buy, for example, a buy call is there in crude, how it looks. Buy crude oil January contract at 3,600 with a stop loss at 3,590 and a target of 3,650. So now this example we have taken just to make you understand how the financials work. So when I say buy crude oil at 3,600 and a stop loss of 3,590, so 3,590 stop loss is nothing but 10 rupee stop loss. So 10 rupee into 100 is the lot. So that makes a risk of 1,000 rupees. What is my target? My target is 3,650. So I have bought at 3,600, sold at 3,650 means 50 rupees is the target. So 50 rupees target into 100 is the lot size. So my target is 5,000. So in simple terms, in this call, my risk is 10 rupees into 100 means 1000 rupees is my total risk. And my target is 50 rupees into 100 shares I have bought. So my target is 5000 rupees total return. So I am going to risk 1000 rupees to earn 5000 rupees in this simple crude oil trade as a new investor based on the research recommendation. Since I am new, I do not know whether to buy or sell, so I will normally follow the research recommendation and I will strictly maintain 10 rupees stop loss, that is 1000 rupees risk, and I will maintain a target of 50 point, which is 5000 rupees reward. So I know in advance now that if I lose, I will lose 1000 rupees, and if I win, I will win 5000 rupees. So this is the life jacket we were talking about in the initial stage. So if I don't know swimming, if I use a life jacket, I will have no chance of drowning. So likewise, if I don't know anything about commodities, I'm putting a 10 rupee stop loss, then I know my risk is maximum 1000 rupees. So I will not drown with 20,000 rupees loss, rather I'll limit my loss to simple 1000 rupees. So repeat the same process of one trade per day. For example, I'm a new investor or trader in commodity. I don't need to trade 10 times in a day. Rather, I will trade only one time in a day. Say, for example, one day, one trade. If I take this as a concept. So crude oil is a commodity I have selected. I have decided my strategy is one day, one trade. I will do only one trade in a day. And I have also predefined my risk should be 1000 rupees in a day. And my reward should be 5000 rupees in a day. If my call goes right, I will earn 5000. If my call is wrong, then I will lose 1000 rupees. So I just need to repeat that for 20 working days, which is 1 month. So if I do 20 working days repetition in a 1 day, if I'm doing one trade, in 20 days, I will do 20 trades. So let us see in a tabular format, okay, what will happen if I'm doing 1 day, one trade. So in simple one, my investment is 20,000 rupees. I have decided to put 1,000 rupees as a risk, that is 10 rupees stop loss. And my target is 5,000 rupees, that means 50 rupees target. So if I do one trade per day for 1 month, 1 month means working days are 20. What will happen at different strike rate? Let us understand. So now this is the strike rate. These are the different strike rate. These are the probabilities. First column says probability 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the probabilities. These are the number of days, which is 1 month, 20 working days. My risk remains same, 1000 rupees per day. My reward is 5000 rupees per day. These are the different strike rate at 70%, at 60%, at 50%, at 40%, at 30%, at 20%. At different research strike rates, what should be my stop loss and target? So let us understand what happens. If I am taking first probability, first probability says my strike rate is 70%. So if I'm going right 70% of the time, out of 20 days, my target will be of 14 days. I mean, out of 20 days at 70% strike rate, I will hit my target on 14 days, and 30% failure is nothing but 6 stop loss days. So in 6 stop loss days, I will lose 6,000 rupees, and in 14 target days, I will earn 70,000 rupees. So 70,000 rupees is profit in 14 good days and 6,000 rupees loss in 6 stop loss days. I will still end up making 64,000 rupees profit. 70,000 minus 6,000, 64,000 is my profit if my strike rate is 70%. Now, let us assume my strike rate is 60% only. So at 60% means out of 20 working days, 12 days I will hit the target, 8 days I will hit the stop loss. Now 12 days I will earn 5,000 rupees. So 12 into 5 is 60,000, and 8 days I will lose 1,000 rupees. That means I'll lose 8,000 rupees. So 60,000 rupees minus 8,000, I'll still make 52,000 rupees profit. So basically, whenever I'm achieving a target, I need to multiply it by 5,000 because that is my target. And whenever I'm hitting a stop loss, I'll have to multiply it by 1,000 because that is my stop loss. Let us assume my strike rate is 50% only. So for example, my strike rate is 50% means out of 20 working days, I have 10 targets and 10 stop loss. So 10 days I'm hitting target, 10 days I'm hitting stop loss. So 10 days my target of 5,000 into 10 days is 50,000 rupees profit. And 10 days my loss is 1,000 rupees into 10 days, 10,000 rupees. So 50,000 rupees minus 10,000 rupees, I'll still get 40,000 rupees profit at a 50% strike rate. Let us assume my strike rate is 40% out of 20 working days. 8 working days I will hit the target and 12 working days I will hit the stop loss. So 8 working days into 5000 is 40000. 12 working days I'm hitting a stop loss means 12 into 1000 is 12000. So 40000 profit minus 12000 loss is still 28000 profit. Let us say my strike rate is only 30%. So out of 20 working days, my calls are going right only 30% of the time, which is 6 days. And 14 days I'm hitting stop loss. So 6 days into 5 is 30000. 14 days into 1000 is 14000. So 30000 profit minus 14000 loss is still 16000 rupees profit. So let us assume in worst case scenario, I will end up making only 20% profit. I mean 20% strike rate. So 20% strike rate means 80% failure. So out of 20 working days, only 4 will hit the target and only and 16 will hit the stop loss. So 4 targets means 4 into 5000 is 20000. 16 stop loss is nothing but 16 into 1000 is 16000. I will still end up making 4000 profit. So this is something which is very simple and logic based trading technique, where you have defined your risk of 1000 rupees per trade and you have defined a reward of 5000 rupees per trade. So you are maintaining a risk reward of 1:5 and you are only doing one trade in a day. And on a given day, when the strike rate is 70%, you are making decent money. When it is 50%, you are still making money. When it is 30% strike rate, still you are making money. And in the worst case scenario, when the 80% of the calls fail, still you are getting 4000 rupees profit. So this is something which should help a beginner to trade safely, where the risk of losing entire 20,000 is not there. When you will lose 20,000 rupees is when all 20 days you will hit the stop loss, that is when your entire 20,000 margin will go zero. But probability of all 20 days going wrong is very minimal, because the research team also does its homework. So at least they will maintain a strike rate of 40-50% with this risk reward ratio. But in the worst case scenario also, if I'm failing 80% of the time, I'll still not lose money because I'm maintaining a favorable risk reward. And since I'm not over trading, I'm only buying and selling one time a day, I think that should not be a problem. So this table should give you an idea how a beginner can trade with limited knowledge, because here you don't need more knowledge on what is crude oil. Basically, you don't need more knowledge of what is going to happen to crude oil. You just need to know what is my risk and what is my reward. So the important thing that you need to know is what is your risk and what is your reward. So your risk is 1000 rupees, which you know. In worst case scenario also, you know, today I might lose only 1000 rupees. And in best case scenario, I will earn 5000 rupees. So here you don't have that fear of drowning or that fear of losing 20,000 rupees. You are very clear of both the outcomes. If I achieve the target, I'll get 5000. If I don't achieve the target, I'll lose 1000 rupees. So the advantage is where with limited knowledge in commodity, you're still able to trade and you're still able to make money out of it. So this is something which you should practice. If you are a newcomer, you want to trade, you start with one lot every day and you check how it goes. You at least try it for 10 days, 20 days. You will get to know how it works. Do not judge on 1 or 2 days performance, because I have seen a lot of clients who have only tried this strategy 1 or 2 days, 3 days. And if 1 or 2 days the stop loss is hit, they say it doesn't work. So that should not be a parameter to judge a strategy whether it works or not. You should give it time. Like in mutual fund, you invest today, you don't make money tomorrow. You have to give that mutual fund a time to grow and multiply. Similarly, in shares also, you buy today and you expect it to grow over a period of 1 year. So here also, for a strategy, you should at least give a month's time. Trade one day, one trade, one lot crude every day for 20 days. Maintain 1000 rupees stop loss, 5000 rupees target every day. And see how it goes for a month's time. I have given different parameters already. So you already know if the strike rate is 40%, you will make 28,000 profit. You already know that if the strike rate is only 30%, still you will make 16,000 profit for your 20,000 investment. You already know if your strike rate is only 20%, still you will make 4,000 profit, gross profit I'm talking about. So here you don't have that fear of losing, or you don't have that fear of having lack of knowledge, because here your product knowledge is not important, your process knowledge is important. I keep on telling my clients with whom I interact, many of them say till the time we don't have product knowledge, it is difficult to make money. I normally correct them and say ki product knowledge is something which you can always, it is a continuous process. You will never be 100% knowledgeable in any product. I have been in commodities from last 16 years, from 2003 itself. But I cannot say today that I have 100% knowledge of commodity. Because I do, then I should be in a position to tell what will happen to crude oil prices tomorrow. Can I predict what will happen to crude oil prices tomorrow? Exactly, I cannot. Likewise, somebody who has experience of 5 years or 10 years in equity, can they predict what is going to happen in Nifty tomorrow because they have knowledge? No, they can't predict. So basically, knowledge may not help you make money. The strategy or the process will help you make money. With a limited knowledge also, you can make money if you have a right strategy in place. One of the simple example is what we have taken: one day, one trade, 1000 risk, 5000 reward, 20 working days consistently, I'll do it and I will see how it works. 2 or 3 days going wrong should not bother you, because do not judge a strategy based on 1 or 2 days or 3 days performance. Give it at least 10-20 days time. If Virat Kohli gets out on zero in couple of matches, you will not throw him out of the team, right? You will see how he has performed over a period of last 100 matches. So you will see that he is a good player, he is a number one player. So you will not judge him as a bad cricketer if he gets out, in 1 or 2 matches on zero. So likewise, no strategy will give you results in 1 or 2 days, 3 days. You should give a systematic approach to it and trade for at least 1 month time, so that you actually enjoy the benefits of this. So like I mentioned, knowledge is something which is a continuous process. You should not stop yourself from knowing about the product, but at the same time, you will never get 100% knowledge. So better option is to find a way to participate in a safer way. Like I have explained one example, similar 20-25 such strategies are available in the market. This is just one example which you as a beginner can still participate. This is something which most of the beginners practice, where there is no complexity. The client is aware I'm risking only 1000 rupees for a day and I'm targeting 5000 rupees. So even if I go wrong 3 days and I go right 1 day, I will still make 2000 rupees profit, is what client is aware of. So this is something which actually helps you participate. So do not let knowledge to stop you from participating from any product. Like if you drive a car, you only know the process knowledge, what the steering function is, what the clutch function is, how the brake and gear works. You only know that. You don't know how the piston is working. You don't know how the carburetor is working. You don't know how the gears inside are changing while you drive a car. So it is not needed. That is technical information. You don't need technical information to drive a car. You just need the basic information of how the steering, clutch, brake and accelerator works. That's it. If you know that, I don't think so you will need to know how the piston is working in the engine, how the carburetor is working, because that is something which is a highly technical knowledge which is not needed. So similarly, what is happening in crude oil globally is something which is a technical information which a research person will take care. You don't have to worry about it. You just need to only focus on the process knowledge, which is how many trades I will do in a day. Say, for example, 1 day per day. Which commodity I'm going to trade in a day? Say, for example, crude oil. What is the margin invested? 20,000. What is the risk I'm going to take? 1,000 rupees. What is the target I'm making? 5,000 rupees. What I will make if the strike rate is 50%, I know that it is 40,000 rupees. What I will make if my strike rate is only 30%, I'll still know ki my return is 16,000 rupees. So basically, you know the process, and I think that should be fair enough to get you on commodities, and you can trade in a safer way. In order to know more, I'm just going to highlight some of the dealing desk numbers here for you. These are the numbers where you can call the dealers, you can take their advice on buying or selling. They have all the research reports with them. They will help you in terms of activating your commodity account also if you have yet not activated by clicking the link. You will also be able to take their advice on whether to buy, whether to sell. If you want to know further, you can call on these numbers anyhow. You can get in touch with them.